everyone. Today we're going to play an act from the play Macbeth, written by William Shakespeare. It is a play about a Scottish general named Macbeth. Macbeth gets a prophecy from three witches that he one day will be the king of Scotland. We will show you what happens in Act 2. We hope you enjoy it. Who's there?
Banquo, it's me, your friend, Macbeth.
Aren't you sleeping yet? The king told me that he was very content with your hospitality.
Oh, I wasn't expecting that, because I wasn't prepared for his visit.
Last night, I dreamed about the three witches. Do you ever think about them?
No, I never really think about that anymore.
Oh.
So, what if I actually would become king, like they said I would?
How do you mean?
Well, if you would stay on my side, I would make honor for thou.
As long as I don't lose honor by trying to gain more.
Don't I want to be loyal to the king then?
Oh, I will always be loyal to the king, no matter who he can be. Maybe.
It's getting late.
Yes, it is. I should go. Bye.
Bye. Is this a dagger which I see before me, with the handle towards my hand? I can't grasp thou. Does that mean thou art a dagger of the mind? A false creation proceeding from my feverish brain? Thou seems so real, but whether thou art real or not, thou art directing me in the way I was going, to kill King Duncan.
I hear the owl squeaking. The time is there. Macbeth did it.
Who is there?
Hello, Macbeth?
I have done the deed. Did you hear any noise?
Yes, I heard the owl squeak. Did thou speak?
What do thou mean?
If thou said something, one word can be fatal, Macbeth.
Thou mean when I was attacking?
Yes.
No, I did not.
I entered quietly, being scared of being heard by a sleeping household. I heard a bell ring, and I said,
I go in this gun. The bell invites me. Herald it not, Duncan, for it is a knell that summons thee to heaven or hell. But who was in the second chamber?
I think it was Dumblebane.
Because there was one in that chamber who was laughing in his sleep, and the other one cried murder. And they woke each other, and I was really scared, but luckily they got back to sleep again.
Yeah, it could be that there were two persons in one room.
I was so scared because the one that was saying God bless thou and amen as if they could see my bloody hands. And I could not say amen because the word was stuck in my throat.
But don't think bad about it. You'll be fine.
But why couldn't I pronounce it?
Don't think about it that way, Macbeth. Don't stress that much.
It seemed to me that someone was saying sleep no more.
What do thou mean?
He told me that I can't sleep anymore.
Who told you you could not sleep anymore? Don't think so feverishly of things. But why did thou bring those bloody daggers with you?
I'm afraid of what I have done, and I won't go back anymore.
Stop it, Macbeth. Give me the daggers, and I will bring them back.
Huh? I hear the knock. Where was that knock coming from? Oh no, my bloody hands. I want to take my eyes out, just so I can't see my bloody hands anymore.
My hands are of your color, but I shame to wear a heart so white. Wait, I heard a knocking. Let's go to a room quickly and wash our hands with water. Hurry up, get on thy nightgown, so nobody will recognize we have been up and awake all night.
Yes, I will, to know my deed. They'd best not know myself. I wish the knocking could wake Duncan, but it's already too late.
If a man were part of Hellgate, he'd had an interesting job. Knock knock, who's there? In the name of Beelzebub, a farmer that hanged himself on the expectation of a good harvest. Come in, time server. Knock knock, who's there? In the other devil's name. Someone who deceives by telling half-truths, an equivocator. Oh, come in, equivocator. Knock knock, who's there? An English tailor. who used less clothes than the customers paid for. Come in, tailor. Knock, knock. This place is too cold for hell. I'm done playing devil porter. I had thought to have let in some of all professions that go to the primrose way to the everlasting bonfire. I'm coming! I'm coming!
Did you oversleep?
Yes, we were drinking until 3 in the morning. And you know what they say about drinking. It's a great encourager of red noses, urine, and sleep.
I believe drink made you lie down last night.
It did, sir, by being poured down my throat.
Anyhow, is thy master stirring?
Good morrow, noble sir.
Good morrow, Macbeth.
Is the king stirring?
Not yet.
He asked me to wake him early.
Oh, I'll show you the way.
Is the king leaving today?
He is planning to. So it is the first door on the right down the hall. It's the king's room.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
It was a wild and stormy night, wasn't it, sir? I swear I heard cries of misery in the air and screams in the depth.
It was a rough night indeed.
Ah!
Horror, horror! Tom Nod's heart cannot conceive or name.
What's the matter?
Most unholy murder has broken open the king's temple and stole the life out of the building.
What do you mean? The king is dead?
Go and see yourself! Approach the chamber and destroy your site with a new Gorgon. Everybody! Banquo! Lady Macduff! Wake up! Wake up!
What is the reason you called me out of my most comfortable bed?
I cannot tell though. The repetition of this information in a woman's ear would murder her as it fell. Oh, Banquo, Banquo, the king has been murdered!
What?
In our house?
This is too cruel to be true. Are you lying, Duff?
From this instant, there is nothing serious in mortality. All is but toys. Renown and grace is dead.
By whom?
I'm going to fight.
It seems like the attendants in his room have done it. Because their faces were all marked with blood, and so were their daggers, which I found on their pillows. I was so mad, I just killed them.
But why did you do so?
My passionate love for the king made me do so and act hastily, before reason could make me stop and think. Who could refrain that had a heart of love, and in that heart courage, to make love known?
Oh, help me, Aunt. Oh.
Oh no, no, look at that lady!
My Lady Macbeth!
Help the lady away, let us all get dressed and question this most bloody piece of work. I put myself under God's protection and we will fight the hidden purposes of wicked traitors.
So will I. Let's get quickly, properly dressed and meet in this hall again. Lady!
Even after the 17 years I've lived this dreadful life, I have made everything I've experienced before seem trivial.
Ah, good father, the heaven, as though disturbed by man's action, are now threatening the earth. But is it the superior power of night, or is the day hiding its face in shame?
It's unnatural. Last Tuesday, a falcon rising to the highest point was attacked by an owl.
How strange. And Duncan's horses, who are the best of their breed, turned wild and broke their stalls.
It's said that they ate each other.
Yes, I witnessed that. I was there.
Oh well, I'm sorry, I gotta go.
Bye.
Bye.
Hey, how are you?
Well, can't you see?
Is it known who is the bloody beast?
Those that Macbeth has slain.
What could they hope to gain by it?
They were bribed. The king's sons have fled, which puts them on the suspicions of deed.
That's another unnatural event. It is a pointless ambition which will gobble up the body that gives you life. Now it's most likely that Macbeth will get the title of the king.
Yeah, he is already named and he already went to Scone, which is the place where all the Scottish kings get grounded.
Where is Duncan's body?
His body is carried to island of Irona, where most of the Scottish kings are buried.
Are you going to Scone?
No, I will not.
Oh, I will go.
Oh, okay, enjoy. I hope we will meet soon again.
Farewell.
Bye. God will go with you, Ross.
Who's there?
It's me.
My throat.
Wow, this is a wall.
You must lachen.
You must lachen.
God will go with you, Ross.
Zij is Ross.
Don't worry, no, well, sir.
About that?
No.